Well, you can already tell that Ragnar Thornquist kicks ass and took a pot shot at the at the bitches reporting, because you know most reporting bitches are kind of stupid and clueless. I don't have any comments. Oh yeah, I do. I particularly love the part where she said, they can't remove altogether. Oh, except through freaking brain surgery. And also the end. The ending was precious. Gilligan's Island. Yeah.
Move along. There is nothing to see here.
Except for that crashed hovercraft.
Nah. You see those everywhere these days.
Oh, really?
Sorry?
Dime a dozen.
Crashed hovercraft are a dime a dozen?
15 a week, ma'am. At the very least. In this city alone.
But they say it's the safest mode of transportation available.
Statistically, yes. Unless you're aboard one of the buggers. Then your chance of survival drops drastically.
What?
They're the safest mode of transportation if you stay on the ground. The chances of being hit by one going down are relatively low.
Thanks for ruining my trust in modern technology.
We're here to protect and serve.
And also sell your products.
Just keep it moving, ma'am. Nothing to see here.
Except for you, officer. Hint, hint.
Except for you, officer.
Hey? Me?
I always did love a man in a uniform.
Sorry, ma'am, but I'm gay. Now, move along. Nothing to see here.
No, you're not.
Except for the escaped convict right behind you.
I'm on special duty today, ma'am. So that escaped convict will have to take care of himself. After all, who'd guard this perimeter in my absence?
Me.
Me? I'll be good.
That was a rhetorical question, ma'am. You are not qualified. Now, move on. Nothing to see here.
Except...
I won't tell you again, so move along. There is absolutely nothing to see here. Nothing. Jeez, don't you people have anything better to do?
Are you feeling all right, officer?
Thank you, ma'am. I'm fine. All the dust from the debris is just choking me up.
It's a police officer. He's guarding the wreckage.
Move along. Nothing to see. Keep it moving, ma'am.
Damn. All right, this is going to play out later on.
If I'm not completely mistaken, and if I remember my tech classes correctly, that's an anti-gravity control unit. It looks fully intact.
We will use that later on, and it will be a small line of quest to get that. You'll see. Everything is for a reason.
Doors are closed.
Oh, snap.
Newport Police Department. It's a holographic sign. It's a police officer. He's guarding the entrance.
Let's speak to him.
Hey! How do I get into the station?
That is the question, is it not?
Pardon?
To get in or not to get in? That is the question.
Very Shakespearean.
Grief, more weirdos.
Oh, I'm not a weirdo. I'm an actor.
No offense, but isn't that an oxymoron?
Lady, you are the cruelest she alive.
How do I get into the station?
You don't. Not today.
But why?
I need to get in. What if there's been a crime?
Good point. I guess you need to report it via one of the many kiosks installed throughout the city, or by contacting an officer of the law.
Like you?
Like yourself?
I am but a humble servant of Her Majesty, and I'm actually assigned to Vice, so don't bother.
Any chance you'll let me through?
Shower me with sweet forgiveness, Princess, but unfortunately, I cannot. The doors ain't working.
The doors aren't working?
They're not. Good Lord, I must report this immediately, after I'm done with my policing exercise.
Did you say the doors weren't working?
Ah, correct. The only things getting in and out of the station today are police officers, prisoners, and garbage.
Aren't they all pretty much one and the same thing?
Cutting words from a wench's barbed mouth?
What did you call me?
A wench.
Sweet princess.
That's more like it.
I prefer wench.
How are you able to bring garbage out and prisoners in when the doors are broken?
These doors don't work, but the gate downstairs does. Of course, you can only get through that inside of a vehicle. The security measures are quite extreme.
They shoot you in the head.
Like how extreme?
Can you say radiation poisoning?
Why were you parading back and forth like that?
I am practicing the fine art of policing.
It's a fine art now, really?
It doesn't look like policing. It looks like acting.
Bollocks! And I thought I was making progress.
You're wrong.
Maybe if you tried being a little less... rigid?
Yeah, but it's this bloody suit. It makes everyone move the same way. I'm not able to release the character.
Are you an actor or a cop?
Both, darling. Both. I am an actor, but I will portray an officer of the law in my next motion picture.
Oh, really?
It's called Mad Cop 2. I play the mad cop's friend, the somewhat ticked off cop.
I think I saw the first one. It stunk.
I agree. But this one has a certain... je ne sais quoi... flair that the original lacked.
You mean more explosions?
You mean more violence, more sex, less plot.
That's it.
Exactly.
So you're doing research for your next role?
Indeed, my fair maiden, I am. I have been assigned to a squad to capture the essence of Her Majesty's honorable service.
We don't have a queen.
What squad would that be?
Vice.
Okay,
thanks,
bye.
And good luck.
Parting is such sweet sorrow. Farewell, princess. Till we meet again, farewell.
Alright then. So the game, we must either become a policeman, a criminal, or garbage. Because you can't become either, let us become garbage. And the way we do that is we move the roadblock somewhere. I think, here or here, and then go into the garbage, and then we'll get picked up.
Perhaps if I try entering the idea of the intersecting street, the roadblock will move.
See? That was the idea. And it works. And now, back in the container. Back, I said. Back! Oh, garbage truck. Come here. There we go.
Keep it close to yourself.
Haha, she'll attack by rats.
The things I do to save the world, I mean that smell, that sticky stuff, the way that rat just wouldn't let go. Disgusting.
Yeah.
Not to mention the fact that I really, truly stink. I don't think this is ever coming off. I'm gonna stink like fish heads and moldy pizza for the rest of my sorry life.
Yeah, that sucks, man.
You can usually tell a crook by his eyes and his foul behavior. Tuvok?
Yes, he looks like Tuvok, actually. Okay, let's...
They don't open manually.
Oh no?
completely secured. I can't open it.
Well, let's speak to the sergeant then. Actually, no, let's call someone.
This phone, 099-12090. It's an old vid phone. Ancient. Officials are so passe.
Alright, screw it, let's call someone. Dial home.
I haven't spoken with Mom since I left, actually. I should give her a ring.
I have a ring. It's gold, too.
Hello? Hi, Mom?
There's her, Mama.
It's April. How are you?
Where are you, sweetheart?
In the city, Mom, you know that.
Why didn't you call? I've been worried sick about you, sweetheart.
Didn't you get my letter?
Yes, and I can't say I understand why.
Well, that was the problem, wasn't it? You didn't understand.
I don't think it was fair of you to be so hard on your father. You hurt him a lot, you know? And I'm not just talking about you pushing him down the stairs.
Ouch.
And what about me? You don't think he hurt me? Were you so blind you didn't see that?
April, you know I can't take sides in this.
No. Of course not. Not you. Not ever. Anyway, how is Dad doing okay? I mean, after the fall.
He broke his arm and he had to take some time off work. Money's short because of that. We had to pull Danny out of school until next semester.
You can't blame me for those things, Mom.
If you hadn't left like you did...
I'd probably be dead now, Mom. I couldn't take it anymore. Please, let's not argue about this now. I just wanted to hear your voice.
Please come home, April. We still love you.
No. Thank you, but no. That's not gonna happen. Listen, I have to go. I'm in the middle of... something. Take care, okay?
Okay, sweetheart. I love you.
Yeah, me too, Mom. Bye.
All right.
It's a toolbox. There's a sheet of paper in here. It's some kind of requisition form or work order.
Let's read it.
Bokama Mercer Corporate Labor Union, form number 09042. Short-term tactical suspension of union members' benefits. It's a carbon copy of an old work order.
Okay, let's put a sergeant then.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Girl.
Yeah, what can I do for you?
Where are the archives?
The archives? You're not an officer of the law, are you?
Actually, yes.
Yes, I am.
If you're a cop, where the hell's your uniform? Your badge? Your standard issue disruptor pistol.
Ooh, pistol.
At home. They're all at home.
Then I suggest you get your cute little butt home and get your badge, your uniform, and your gun. Capiche? Now shoo, leave the grown-ups to do the grown-up work, okay?
About the archives.
You're not an officer of the law, are you?
I'm in training at the academy, and I need to get into the archives to... study.
You're in training? Uh-huh, sure you are. Then what the hell you doing here? You should be at the academy doing push-ups and learning how to bullshit like a pro.
Oh, I can already do that.
About the archives.
You're not an officer.
So what if I'm not?
Then you can't go into the back, capiche? Cops only. Besides, half the doors in this building, including that one, are out of order. Nobody's going in, nobody's coming out.
Well, damn.
And until those overpaid, underworking service guys get off their butts and back to work, that's the way it's gonna stay.
Thanks anyway.
Alright, so next order of business. Get these two to get off their butts.
It's a thin guy wearing red coveralls. He looks like a repairman. It's a portly fellow wearing red coveralls. I think he's a repairman. Hiya.
Huh? You an angel from heaven come to take me away?
No point talking to old Georgie there. Ever since he overdosed on raptures, he ain't been right in the head. I don't ever let him hold the hammer no more either, I'll tell you that.
Alright, let's talk to this portly fella then.
Hi.
What do you want? We're on our lunch break, honey.
Why aren't you guys working?
We're on our contractually bound lunch break.
Right. But you're not eating.
We're done eating, sure. But we're still on our break. Clause 16 of the contract, and I quote, improper digestion may prove detrimental to further work-related activities. End quote.
Meaning what?
We're letting the corned beef settle, honey.
Sounds legit.
Aren't you supposed to fix the doors?
That's right.
But instead you're just... sitting here.
That's right.
And you're not planning on getting back to work anytime soon?
That's right.
And you're not bothered by this?
That's right.
That's right.
I could say anything, anything at all.
That's right.
And you just answer...
That's right.
Well, how's that for productivity? Yeah, that's right.
Right.
It'd be so nice if you could fix the doors.
And it would be so nice if you could go away and leave us alone.
Nuh-uh, not doing that.
Is there anything I can do to make you go back to work?
No. Short of emergency, we ain't moving our asses in the foreseeable future.
What constitutes an emergency?
Any event accompanied by a specific work order signed in triplicate.
Triplicate?
What kind of work order?
You know.
I don't.
About the work order...
Yeah? Which one?
You know, for emergencies.
You mean the short-term tactical suspension of union members' benefits requisition form?
He said.
Sure.
Well, if you were to produce said requisition with the appropriate signatures, we'd be forced to prematurely suspend our lunch break, for tactical reasons, of course.
Sure, tactical reasons.
Thus allowing our scheduled work to be completed.
Don't you just love bureaucracy?
You what?
Never mind.
You're a dumbass.
Where do I go to get the requisition form?
What form?
The requisition form for the short-term tactical suspension of... of union member benefits.
Any official office for which we perform services.
Oh yeah.
Excuse me. How do I smell?
Chanel.
Smell? Are you coming on to me, honey?
What?
I don't know. Women don't usually come on to me, so I'm just checking.
I wouldn't want to miss a come on.
Oh, you're a dork.
I asked you how I smelled.
Yeah, right. Moldy pizza and... is that salmon?
Smoked.
Yeah. And a faint touch of rum?
Yo ho ho.
I had an accident with a bottle inside a garbage container.
Happens to me all the time. You're not alone. In fact, there are meetings downtown every Wednesday night.
I don't have a drinking problem.
If you can't admit it to yourself, honey, you do. After all, who's the one reeking of rum? Not me, that's for sure. Not today, anyway.
Enjoy your lunch break, guys.
With the Sunday overtime we're getting? You betcha, honey.